Joining us now is a guy who's probably pretty happy about that. Matt Grzelcyk, welcome to the show. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for having me on.
Where did you watch the Super Bowl last night, if you don't mind me asking? I mean, big win for the Bruins yesterday over the Capitals. Then you get to watch the Super Bowl. What did you guys do?
We had a little team party that Zdeno Chara put together and some of the older guys. So it was nice to watch the game with some of the wives and the kids as well. And yeah, we had a good time watching the Pats win.
Yeah, it was a huge day in Boston sports yesterday because the Bruins beat the Capitals. I don't know if anything else went on, but I know that the Bruins have had their troubles. You guys have had your troubles with the Washington Capitals, as many teams have, because the Caps are a pretty good team. What was it like for you guys to go in there and finally get a win and 1-0 of all things?
Yeah, it was certainly a relief. It's kind of no secret that they've had our number over the years. And, you know, like you said, they're a really good team. A lot of high-powered offense. So to win in a 1-0 game was probably unlikely. But, you know, Tuukka played great for us all night and gave us a great chance to win. And we were able to get one there in the second. Thankfully, that's all we needed.
Grizz, congrats to you. Congrats to me on the championship for Boston and in our wonderful city. I was saying last night that when they won their first one, I was a freshman at BU with an afro. Go BU. You went there also. I had no clue in life.
Not a big deal.
18 years later, you know, they win again. Where were you on their first one? Were you still in diapers?
Yeah. I actually remember that one, running through the streets of Charlestown with pots and pans banging with some of my friends. I was probably about 5 or 6 years old, but it's crazy to see how far the city's come.
I got to ask you, because the game was, you know, by most people's standards, pretty boring last night. What was the highlight of the game for you?
Probably just the final. Yeah, I guess the final drive where, you know, Brady led the charge on the field and Gronk made that huge catch. You know, it was a kind of a little bit of a boring game, but also I had 0-0 in the squares, so I won the first quarter, so I'm not too bad.
Of course you did.
Yeah, obviously.
Hey, it's always good to win under any circumstances, so congratulations on that personal victory as well. I want to ask you about your dad. I mean, most people do know the story. Your dad had worked at the Boston Garden for many, many years, moved over to the TD Garden as part of the crew there, getting things ready in the building. What was it like for you growing up with that? I guess you had some access to that building from time to time. What was it like as a kid?
Yeah, it was obviously a unique experience and something I try not to take for granted. Obviously, just getting to be around some of the players and to go to some of the events was really cool. And it kind of felt normal to me growing up. But, you know, looking back at it now, it was definitely a unique experience. And, you know, glad to have, you know, a good amount of photos to kind of capture those moments.
Grizzy, you know, you mentioned to us here getting your haircut, getting the ears lowered. Where are you at right now? Charlestown? You stay there? You move on somewhere else?
No, I usually go to the same barbershop I've been my whole life, but they opened up a new spot up in Assembly Row in Somerville, so it's the same barber, but just at a different location right now.
You got to stick with your guy. Like, once you find your person, when it comes to everybody knows that. Yeah. Like, once you find
your
person.
Once you know what you like, you can't stray from it.
Absolutely. No, it's too risky. all right. I don't know if you know this, but your last name is very tough to spell. I'm curious how many times in your hockey life it has either been misspelled or mispronounced.
I can't even count anymore. I think Bruce Cassidy still has no idea how to say it, and at this point, that's completely fine with me. I've had to do it too many times my whole life, so it doesn't bother me at all.
Have you ever had a jersey where it's spelt wrong on the back?
Not from what I can remember, but plenty of name plates going up in the locker room. But yeah, like I said, it just gets old after a while, so I don't let it bother me.
Fair enough. Well, we want to have a little fun with you and see if you can spell some of your teammates' last names. Are you game?
Oh, boy.
We'll
see how this goes.
That's the question.
We won't quiz you on your own last name. But, okay, so here's how it's going to work. I'm going to give you the name. You only have to spell the last name. And you can just give us letters, and once you get a letter wrong, you'll just hear a big, you know, like, Price is Right.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Your first one, Achari.
Acciari.
Got it. Okay, Okay, off to a good start.
Nailed it.
Be you.
Was there no ding? There needs to be a ding.
There should be a ding.
Oh, there was a ding. There was a ding. There we go. There we go. Okay. How about Krejci?
K-R-E-J-C-I.
Oh.
Yes. Yes.
I didn't know where the C and the J was going, but.
Nice. You nailed it.
But you had a 50-50 shot, and you got it.
Got it.
All right, this next one, I'm not even going to lie. I'm nervous to even say it because it doesn't sound at all like it looks, and my brain can't comprehend that sometimes. Solaric.
Oh, boy. C-E-H. L-A-R-I-K.
Oh, come
that's
on. Awesome.
Come on.
That's we can't even give him the last one.
Does he have a program in front of him there?
Not a big deal.
And I quote. All right, one more for you. This isn't a teammate of yours, so we're just trying to put you on the spot here. EJ's last name's pretty tough. It's Radic. Do you know how to spell
Radic? He's never going to get that.
Radic.
Oh, my God.
Never get it.
Doesn't it begins with an H, right?
Oh, yay! Correct. Yes, good
now
start,
you got
good
it.
Start.
Now you got it. Sound that out now.
H R A D E K.
Oh my God!
What
gosh.
An animal this is! What an animal! A genius!
Right, I'm a little bit smarter than I appear. I've had to deal with bad last name spelling, so.
Wow!
New haircut will make you look even smarter, I bet.
Boy. Exactly.
I gotta tell you, I've gotten my own last name wrong on several occasions. So that's great. Yep. I mean, that's
awesome.
I've watched NHL Network too many times to know it.
That's what happened.
I'm with him every day, and when I include him in a tweet, I honestly have to look it up.
I have to look it up. That's right. I mean, listen, so do I.
That's awesome.
Blame you.
All right, 4 for 4. Well played. Thanks for your time today. Enjoy the haircut. We appreciate the time.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Have a good one.
Have a good one.